Hey there everyone, welcome to California. I'm about to show you a moon tree. That's right, a moon tree. Now there are moon trees all over the world, not just here. They're mainly in the United States, and another place you can find them is the good state of Alabama. That's where my friend Destin lives, so I asked him if he'd also help me out in, what should we call this, Operation Moon Tree?
Roll Tide, Brady. I am more than willing to take on this assignment from you. I am pulling up next to the U.S. Space and Rocket Center right now. We're about to go inside and check out some Apollo stuff and talk about moon trees.
Okay, so what exactly is a moon tree? Well, a moon tree is a tree grown from seeds that were taken to the moon. Seeds taken to the moon? Basically, about 500 seeds were taken to the moon by an astronaut called Stuart Roosa. He was the command module pilot of Apollo 14. Now, before he was an astronaut, Roosa was what's called a smoke jumper.
Smoke jumpers, parachute firefighters. One answer to the problem of fire in remote, roadless areas.
So he had an association with trees, and he was asked if he'd take these seeds on his voyage to the moon. He agreed.
Okay, check it out. This is the Saturn V. This is what took the seeds to the moon. We're gonna go to the end of the museum here and see if we can look at the Apollo capsule, which I don't know if the seeds were actually in there or not at some point, but I guess it would have to if it returned to Earth. Come on, let's go check it out. All right, so this is the Apollo 16 command module. So this is not Apollo 14, which is what the seeds were actually taken on. But still, the Apollo program was stinking awesome. Here's a moon rock, by the way.
Stuart Roosa didn't actually walk on the moon. That was Alan Shepard and Edgar Mitchell. Roosa stayed above in the command module called Kitty Hawk, basically orbiting the moon, waiting for his buddies to come back. He didn't mess around while he was up there, though. He had a lot to do. He actually took a lot of photos of the moon.
And so while the guys were down on the surface of the moon, these seeds were going around the moon right there. So the seeds didn't actually touch down on the moon, but they did go around the moon. After that, they went back up, they rendezvoused, and then they came all the way back. And that's when the seeds went to Mississippi, which is where they started to sprout. Once they were sprouted, they got handed out all over the nation, even to other countries, and we're gonna go try to find one of those trees right now.
So my moon tree is one of these here. It's actually surprising sort of how hidden away it is. You'd think it'd be out on grand display, really important, but this one's, well, it's not easy to find if you don't know what you're looking for.
Well, now, unfortunately, there were seven here at the Space and Rocket Center, but in the 80s they died.
Oh, well, I guess that's bound to happen to some of the trees. Now, where are we? It's around here somewhere. I tell you what, this is hard work making these educational YouTube videos. No messing around.
Okay, we don't know exactly where the trees were planted. It was somewhere here at the Space and Rocket Center. So in order to figure out what the whole ground was like,
we're riding space shot.
Oh, goodness. Okay, somewhere over there. The trees were planted somewhere over there. Not really sure where. Did you like that?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Hannah.
Hannah didn't like it. I loved it. I thought it was great. Oh. The seeds were up there, they went to the moon, they came back, they were planted somewhere over here, and they died. But we're gonna go see if we can find a tree that actually survived. There was no countdown or anything. Gabooya! So we're gonna go to Birmingham Botanical Gardens and see if we can find the only one that I'm aware of here in the state. Let's go check it out. Keep my glasses on.
Launch commit, liftoff. We have liftoff on Apollo 14, 3 minutes past the hour.
Houston, Barrett, here, go for the moon, go for TLI.
This is it. This is my moon tree. If you don't believe me, have a look at this surprisingly unimpressive little sign hidden away down here. Coast Redwood, Sequoia sempervirens, moon tree in quotation marks. The seed from which this tree sprang was taken to the moon.
How's it going?
Hi, how are you?
Doing good. We're looking for the moon tree.
Moon tree. Let me show you.
Okay. Let's go find the moon tree. So there's a guy in England. His name is Brady. And yeah. He has an educational YouTube channel. And he's making a video about moon trees. And he sent me up here to find the moon tree. So could I get seeds from this tree and have a second generation? Is that how that works?
Yeah. Because we've done it before. We've actually collected seed and we sent it to a Michigan arboretum.
So that leads nicely to the issue of second generation moon trees. I'm sure you can figure out what they are. These are the sons and daughters of original moon trees, of first generation moon trees. Just take the seeds, plant them somewhere else. And it sounds to me like Destin's lining himself up for a second generation moon tree in his backyard in Alabama.
Can we climb in there and see if we can find a seed?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Come on, let's go. Mr. Taylor said we could.
Do you know what a moon tree is?
No.
What would you guess a moon tree is?
A moon tree.
A moon tree.
Their branches are shaped in a crescent.
Oh, that's a good guess. It's not right, but it's
that's
a good
right.
guess. No. It was grown from seeds that were taken to the moon by astronauts.
Oh,
okay.
Wow. Now that I wouldn't have thought of, but that's interesting.
Yeah.
Do you see any sycamore seed pods? I don't know what they look like. Do you?
So Destin's moon tree, that's a sycamore. Mine here, this is a redwood. And there were three other types, sweet gums, firs, and pines. They're your moon trees. That's the five types of seeds that Stuart Ruser took to the moon.
I'm gonna touch the bark. So this tree came from a seed that went to space. Not only did it go to space, it went around the moon.
There you go, Destin. I'll send you those bad boys.
Brady, we're not gonna find any seeds. They keep it too clean around here. It looks like they trimmed it at one point in time. Man, that thing is big, isn't it?
Look at that, there's the moon. And there's the moon tree. Moon, moon tree, moon. Moon tree.
So what I think is cool about moon trees is that means that seeds are completely transportable. Like it's a little unit of life that goes dormant and you can do whatever you want with it and it's still gonna work.
Ruser, Mitchell and Shepard, they've all died now. In fact, Apollo 14 is the first mission for which all three astronauts have passed away. So it's somehow fitting that they're the ones that have left us with this legacy of Apollo. Not a statue, not a stone or a metal monument, but something living. And through second generation moon trees, and maybe third, fourth, fifth generation moon trees, a way that we can always remember one of humankind's greatest accomplishments. If you've never seen Destin's YouTube channel, Smarter Every Day, I'm amazed you haven't, but you really should. It's not only one of the best educational channels on YouTube, it's one of the best channels on YouTube, full stop. Make sure you check it out. Links are on the screen, description, all the usual places.
What?
I was thinking, if they took eggs to the moon and then brought the eggs back and hatched them, you could have moon chickens.
But they wouldn't have big legs, so you couldn't eat them.
No, but you could, I don't know, yeah, you could just have them as a pet.
I have a moon chicken.